The easiest way to enable the dark mode in Google Docs or Google Sheets is with a browser extension. Each browser, Chrome, Edge, Firefox, Safari, has its own extension store. I'm using Google Chrome, but the extensions we will compare are available across all major browsers. To get started, visit the extension store and search for dark mode. You will find a variety of options. Be sure to check the ratings and the number of reviews. I will compare the three most frequently recommended. The first extension I want to test is Google Docs Dark Mode. Click the Add to Chrome button to install it. Pin the extension to the top of your browser for easy access. In the Manage Extensions section, you will find several options. But the first thing you will need to do is relaunch the browser for the extension to take effect. Once the browser is relaunched and you open Google Docs, you will notice that the menu and ribbon at the top are now in dark mode. A new extension menu appears on the right side of the document. The moon icon at the top indicates that dark mode is active. If you click on it, the icon changes to a sun, switching the view to a light mode. Below that, there's a page icon. When the icon shows a white page, it means that Google Docs canvas remains white. Clicking it again turns the canvas black, applying dark mode to your document area. Notice that all the elements that were previously blue turned yellow, and the image colors are inverted. This extension only affects Google Docs. Other pages like Google Drive and Google Sheets are not impacted, which is why it's called Google Docs Dark Mode. You can disable the extension in the settings, but the change will take effect only after you relaunch your browser. Google Docs Dark Mode is a pretty decent dark mode extension, but is limited to Google Docs. It has a big base of 600,000 users and an average of 3.4 star rating from over 1,000 reviewers. To activate it, you do need to relaunch your browser, and it has a two-step process for enabling the dark mode. Additionally, you can't adjust the colors, some are inverted and can be harsh. The next extension I tested is the Dark Reader. After adding it to your browser, it takes effect immediately. No need to relaunch your browser. To manage the extension, click on the three-dot menu for more options. At the top, there's a quick on and off toggle that switches the entire Google Docs page to dark mode. Unlike the other extension, you don't have to separately adjust settings for the menu, ribbon, and document area. Everything turns dark with one click. This extension works across all tabs, including Google Sheets and Google Drive, which are fully converted to dark mode. I like that the colors are less harsh when compared to the Google Docs Dark Mode extension, which looked overly inverted. With the Dark Reader, you can adjust the brightness, contrast, and even soften the white text by increasing the sepia tone. There's also an option to make the black more gray, reducing the intensity. Additionally, all my other tabs, like Gmail and YouTube, are also in the dark mode. This makes sense, as users who prefer dark mode often want it applied universally, not just Google Docs. Disabling the extension is simple. Just toggle it off and refresh the page, with no need to relaunch the browser. With over 5 million users and best 4.7 star rating from over 11,000 reviewers, Dark Reader is a great dark mode extension. It works seamlessly on all websites, activating instantaneously, and offers user-friendly options for adjusting the colors in the dark mode. The last extension I tested is Dark Mode Night Eye. First, I will add it to my browser, pin it, and select it. Then I will go to Settings to review my options and set Dark Mode as the default. Once I refresh Google Docs, Dark Mode is activated, which appears similar to the Dark Reader. The colors are more subdued and less harsh compared to the Google Docs Dark Mode extension. All other pages like Google Sheets, Google Drive, Gmail, and YouTube are also set to dark mode, though you may need to refresh them for the extension to take full effect. If you select the extension at the top, you will get a small pop-up letting you adjust the brightness, contrast, saturation, and even blue light. You can apply these settings to all pages or just the current one. However, it has way too many steps, screens, too much reading at each step, and hard to tell what each option is. I prefer the quick and easy one screen adjustments of Dark Reader. To disable the Night Eye extension, simply slide the toggle to off and then refresh each page, or relaunch the browser to apply the changes across all pages at once. The Dark Mode Night Eye is a relative newcomer with over 200,000 users and a very good 4.4 star rating from over 2,000 reviewers. It works across all websites, though you may need to refresh the page for it to take effect. The colors are gentle and you do have some control over adjustments, but the pop-up options box is overly complicated. If at any point you want to completely remove any of the dark mode extensions, first go to Manage Extensions. From there, click Remove for each one: Dark Reader, Dark Mode Night Eye, and Google Docs Dark Mode. And so, the winner is the Dark Reader.
Yay!
Closely followed by Night Eye and Google Docs Dark Mode being last, although it's still a decent dark mode extension for Google Docs. In the next video, I will go over how to implement dark mode in Google Docs without an extension. Thanks so much for watching.